Hey Matterporters, in this customization video, I want to talk about the labels and measurement tools. So let's go ahead and get right to it. You can see right here is my labels tool. And if I just go ahead and click on that, out comes the drawer panel that is expandable just like all the other tools. So I can collapse this or expand it. And I just want to point that out because I've come into a tool before and the drawer has been collapsed and it's a little bit confusing. So just so you know, not necessarily every time that you click on a tool will the drawer automatically open up. It might be collapsed and that just means that you have to expand it. Up here we have the floors for the model, and just like the other tools that show me the floors, I can go ahead and rename the floors. And this name will show up in the floor selector icon right here for your visitors. So you can do this floor name change in any tool that shows you the floors. So I'll just keep mine as floor 2, just click away there. And if I expand this, you can see that I already have a label right here. It shows me here too that I have one label on floor 2 and 0 labels on floor 1. To add a new label, it's really simple. Just like with any other tool, you just click the add button down here. And as soon as I do that, you'll see that it gets me to the floor plan view. And this is because the floor plan view is the only view that you can actually see and create labels. As I move my cursor around the model to position my label, you can see that different regions of the model become highlighted. This is all based on machine learning and isn't going to have any kind of effect on where I position the label. So I can place the label anywhere I want, regardless of what's being highlighted or not. So I'll just go ahead and place the label here and then click bedroom. You can see that a common list of labels already appears and I can just finish it off by saying bedroom. I'll click add again and place another one here and call this one bathroom. And again, you can see that it finishes it off and I can just tap that to include this. I can of course grab my label and move it anywhere I want. Grab this one, move it anywhere I want. And once a label is highlighted, I can go ahead and click the pencil icon to edit that label if I want to rename it. When you're done editing, just go ahead and click enter on the keyboard to execute your edits. And now I can go ahead and continue adding or deleting any labels I want. As I'm adding more and more labels, you can see them appear in the drawer over here. Now you'll notice that all of the labels that I've currently added are being placed on floor 2. And that's because I have floor 2 currently selected. So this is really something that you want to take note of and make sure that the correct floor is selected before placing your labels. So I'll go ahead and change this to floor 1. And now I can position more labels on floor 1. Just by pressing the plus or add button down here and adding more labels. So now that I'm done placing all my labels where I need them to be, I'll just go ahead and close out of this tool and hit preview so I can see what I've done. And now when I go into the floor plan view, you can see that the labels I've placed are right here. Now I can see only the first floor labels because I'm currently only looking at the first floor. If I choose to see the second floor, the first floor labels disappear and I only see the second floor. What if you have all the floors selected? You can see that areas from the first floor, like the staircase, appear in my model, but still I can only see the second floor labels. Now let's go ahead and check out the measurements mode. If I go back to edit and then click on measurements, again, out comes the drawer and currently have 0 measurements on the first floor and 0 measurements on the second floor. So let's go ahead and place some measurements. You'll notice that I'm currently in the floor plan view. And your measurements are categorized in 2 different ways. They're either floor plan measurements or any other view measurements. What that means is if you're placing a measurement in the dollhouse or inside view, you'll only be able to see those measurements in either of those views. And if you place the measurement in the floor plan view, you'll only be able to see that measurement in the floor plan view. Before we get to drawing any measurements, I just wanted to bring your attention to the settings button right up here. If I tap this, you'll see the exact same options that a visitor would have if they choose to draw measurements in Showcase. The top option here shows that snapping is currently turned on. I'm gonna leave mine on because I'll show you in a second how to temporarily turn it off as you're drawing the measurement. Continuous lines is also turned on. I'll leave this on for now and show you exactly what that does. And my units of measurement is set to US Imperial instead of metric. So I'll leave this as it is and I'll just press the settings button to collapse that window. Now to draw my measurement line, I just press the add button right here and I'll go ahead and start my measurement right here. Just click once and drag my line to the other side of the room and click again. Now, because I have that continuous lines option selected, it's going to want to draw another line. So this is exactly what that means. Now I can press the escape button, as you see here, or I can come down to the green check and just press that if I don't want to continue any further. The advantage of having that continuous lines option selected is this: if I add a new measurement and I start my measurement over here, for example, I'll come over here to see the length of this room, tap here, and then I can come up here without going to add a whole new measurement. And then I can click again. Now those two lines are drawn and I can stop at this point. So again, just press escape or come down here to click the green check mark. Now the nice thing is when I select this measurement, not only do I see the measurement of each segment, but I can also up here see the total of both. Alternatively, if I choose to turn this setting off, I'll go ahead and check this off and then hit add. What this is going to allow me to do is place a measurement, and once I click, that measurement then stops, but I don't have to press the add button to add a new measurement. I can just go and place another measurement and a third measurement, and every time I click, a new measurement is added. Once I'm done, just hit the check mark, and I've got all these three measurements done. As I said before, these measurements are only going to be visible to your visitors in the floor plan view. So once I go to the dollhouse view, you can see that they disappear. Now let's go ahead and measure the first floor. I'll just go down here to the first floor, and let's say I want to see how wide the doorway is right here. I can just zoom into this scan position and I'll press the add button. And you can see that the crosshairs are snapping to edges and corners of my mesh that's sitting behind the 2D image. So I don't want this to happen in this case because maybe it's not quite snapping to the right location. So what I can do is hold down the Option or Alt key on my keyboard, and you can see now it just follows the mesh and the snapping is temporarily disabled. So I'll just place my start position right here, click once, drag over here, and again, because I released that Option button, it's snapping to areas that I don't want. So I'll hold down the Option button again and I'll measure right over here. I'll just press the green check mark. After placing a measurement using the inside or dollhouse view, I like to move around a little bit and see it from different positions just to make sure that it's accurate. So I'll just look at this from a couple different positions. Maybe try and move over here. So it does look indeed like it's correct. I can even see it from the dollhouse view and just move around to make sure that it is accurate. And I'm happy with that. Now, if I look back in the drawer, you can see that I have one measurement line drawn on floor one and five measurement lines drawn on floor two. Now, another thing I can do with my measurement lines is add a label to the measurement line itself. And the way you do that is in the drawer right here. If I expand this floor, I can see that my measurement line is right here. It says 2 feet 6 inches. And I can press the three-dot menu here and I can say rename and add a label there, and you can see it appear in the measurement. Now, one thing to keep in mind when adding labels to your measurements is that it could make your measurements disappear depending on how you're looking at the model. So let me show you exactly what I mean by that. So if I have a shorter measurement, for example, I'll draw one right here, and then I choose to label that measurement, I am limited to the number of characters that I can add to a measurement's label. But let's say I go ahead and max that out. You can see here I have this really big label, and if I close out of this tool and choose to preview, I'll go to the floor plan view and look at floor two. I click measurements. You can see that the label is kind of faded out. In this case, that label is just too large, so I'm not going to be able to see my measurement. And this is, again, because that label is just too big. So I'll go ahead and edit this. Go into measurements, change this to be a little bit shorter. And now I'll preview again. Now you can see the label as well as the measurement, because again, my label is short enough. And that's really all there is to it. I hope you take advantage of these tools to further customize your models and help your visitors better understand the model, as well as help you better collaborate with your visitors.